now, the voice of the new vibration, Hillary Harris.
Hello, fellow sojourners and dragon family. Welcome to another video cast of Ascension 360, Navigating the New World Energies. This is where we talk about what the heck is up on planet Earth and how it may be affecting you. I am Hillary Harris. I'm an intuitive solutions strategist, passion to purpose facilitator, dragon communicator, and your ascension guide on this steep climb that we continue to be on as we ascend into higher human divine essence. So I want to talk about a very interesting theme that has emerged for 2021 and beyond. There are several important themes that I will be talking about that are really critical to understand. Today I want to talk about the theme of emergence. And this actually, information came to me through the dragons. They have been extremely instrumental in bringing in some very high-level, profound messaging, and this is one of them. So let me talk about what this actually means or how it showed up. The dragons a few years ago asked me to paint. They kept asking me to paint, and I heard it over and over, and I, you know, got some of the supplies and said, yeah, you know, I'll get to it. But I really wasn't taking it on seriously. I was doing a little bit of chalk drawing and kind of playing around with it, but I wasn't really heeding the message. And last year, or perhaps a year and a half ago, somebody saw an interview that I was giving, and I was talking about one of the topics I love to talk about, the inner dragon essence, embracing that essence and unleashing the dragon nature and fire that's within us. And behind me was a dragon painting that I had come across when I first moved south. And I was looking for confirmation and affirmation and, you know, all of that good messaging that I was in the right place. And so I ended up with that particular painting. So I often have that in the background when I do interviews. And an artist in Vienna saw that interview and he contacted me and he said, and I hadn't discussed this before anywhere, he said, you know, the dragons want you to paint. And I said, yeah, I know. But I hadn't gotten to it. And so he agreed to be my mentor, to guide me a little bit, encourage me, give me any kind of assistance and help me learn, because I don't know anything and I didn't know anything about painting. I knew a little bit about art and drawing, but certainly not painting. And you know, what kinds of paints did I want to use and just all of that. But over time I started, and I certainly will be sharing more of what I painted more publicly. But one of the things that occurred to me in the beginning of 2021 was how my painting had actually changed. In the beginning, I was just painting whatever it is that came to me. Often the dragon would come through, the dragon imaging would come through. But I'm not good at sketching something out and then painting over it. I don't like having to do that. I wanted it to be very freeform and fun. Otherwise, I would end up, you know, crumpling it up and throwing it over my shoulder. And that's one thing that my mentor kept saying, you know, it has to be fun. This isn't going to work. And one of the things that the dragons require is play. That's their currency to provide information. So that's a good reminder for us to play. But what they asked me to do was to just paint along the blank canvas, whether it's just one color or several different colors, to create a background, and that's it. So I was just painting these backgrounds and just leaving it. And what they then said is just look at the painting and let the image emerge. Just let it come forward. And so as I started to look around the canvas, I was finding the imagery, and out popped out dragons, beautiful dragons, dragons that I could not have tried to create if I was doing it in this very intellectual manner. You know, really starting out and sketching it and making sure the proportions were right and, you know, the ears were right and the scales were looking perfect and the spikes and, you know, just all of that. So I'm going to show you some of that imagery now so that you can see how I started with a blank canvas, Then I moved to painting the background. And again, the background could be a single color, or often I would mix in, you know, similar colors. Like if it was just yellow, I might do different shades or tonalities of yellow, or many different colors. And then I would just take time to sit and look at it. So sit in stillness, just let my mind go and let the dragon or whatever image was going to be there emerge.
So here you can just see the blank canvas with all my paints where it starts. Here I took a canvas that I didn't like at all, and I just started painting color on top of it, covering it up just to see what might get created as a result. And in sitting and looking at it, if you take a look at the bottom center, you might see what I saw. There's something there. It looks like a neck and a head. So then I started to fill in the details, and you can see what began to emerge. Then I filled in more details of the face, the teeth, the nose, the ears. And then I sat with that a while and then felt like it was trying to show me a tail. The tail was coming forward. So I filled in those details. And at the very end, I wasn't quite sure whether I wanted to add the wings. And if you look carefully, you can see that there is a hint of, there is an essence of the wings. And I just decided to leave that because that was very representative of the whole concept that the dragons were teaching me. And this, in this painting is what I started to understand. So I allowed the dragon to look like it was emerging up from underneath, but also coming forward. And I thought just leaving those wings as a hint, as a suggestion, was a really nice way to bring forward this concept of emergence. The next canvas is actually the second panel of the painting that I didn't like, and I still had another panel to go. And so again, I just started painting over it. I started adding some whites and some lighter colors to kind of bring in an effervescent effect, or kind of a glowing from within. And as I sat and looked at that, and if you take some time to really just sit and look, you might see what was emerging for me. All of a sudden, I saw a mouth and a nose and the smoke, and I filled it in from there. And this is what emerged for this one. This next canvas is really fun. I knew I wanted to do something on bright yellow. I didn't know exactly what was going to show up, and just a bright bolt of color. I loved this orange. And of course, as I continued to paint and create, I saw what I thought was just going to be a tail and leave it at that. But again, if you sit and look at the end of the tail, what emerges is an eye, the nose, the mouth. You can see actually that it's a dragon's head. How fun is that, right? Now this last painting might be one of my favorites. It's sort of more mystical or magical in nature. Again, I started painting just back and forth with these deeper purple and blue tones, which is very dragon-esque. And then a zigzagging or spiral image started to emerge from the painting. And I just wasn't sure exactly what to do with it until I looked in the lower right-hand corner. And if you look carefully in that corner, you might see what is the hint of a head. So I flipped the painting upside down and brought forward the vision of the dragon head that I saw.
So as you can see in these images, all that was happening was that I was allowing what was to emerge. Now, this is very critical to this new way of being in this higher dimensionality. So it's not about having a specific vision board and we know exactly what the vision is and that's what we focus on. Because what's happening is we're trying to build something new from the old or on the old platform, and that's not going to work. We certainly don't want to bring onto a new platform all the old. Right? So what it is we already know. We already know that this or that exists as something to create, for example, for a career. Or maybe you're just trying to come up with a design for something creative like a t-shirt or for a meal. So whatever it is, even a relationship, you may have thought, well, this is the way my relationships have always been. I want to do it differently, but this is what I know. So I'm going to sit and I'm going to write it all down. And nothing wrong, again, with that methodology, but you want to make sure that there's room for just leaving the canvas blank and allowing what is to be yours to emerge. It's a really beautiful, effortless process, and it's very different. I had to give up complete control because all I was doing was laying down the paint, and there was no, well, this is where I want the ear to go, and this is where I want the neck and the tail. I simply had to trust that once I put the paint down, when I just sat and let it be, that that image would emerge. So again, take a look at that imagery and see how it is that I just found the dragon. First, I might have found something else, like what I thought was a close-up flower, a thorn and flower bush, or like a rose bush, or a tree. And yet, always a dragon emerges. And again, I'm not trying to do it. I really am not trying to do it. I just allow myself to lay the paint down as it comes to me. It's an extremely organic, intuitive process. This is how we bring things forward. It's not anymore about manifesting. It's about allowing what is to emerge from what it is that you place out there purely and from the heart. And it does take some practice. And, you know, if you're up for it, try it. Try it with some paint. Try it with crayons. Try it with sand or dirt. You know, when you go out in with your kids, maybe to the sandbox or in the garden. Just allow what is to emerge in your life, in your world, in your heart, with your loves, and see what happens. I promise you, and the dragons guarantee, that what emerges will be more extraordinary, more delightful, and more surprising than you could ever imagine. So remember the process, laying it all out there and allowing it to emerge, and then let yourself be delighted. Now, if you like these video casts, I please encourage you to subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so that you know whenever a new video cast is published, and click that like icon as well so that more people can find me and receive these messages and information, and feel free to pass them along to your friends. And I look forward to you once again tuning in to tune up your vibration.
Thank you for listening to Ascension 360. Join Hillary again next time as she brings us even more mind-expanding information to guide us over the dimensional border and into the energies of the new world. I'm so-